Hello learners, I am Dr. Sunita Sundrial. Welcome to NIOS studio. Today we shall take up functions of management. This is a content of paper 507, Community and Elementary Education. This is paper of D.El.Ed program run by NIOS on online mode for distance learners. So before we begin the functions of management, let us understand what are the aims and objectives of the functions of management. Today we will try to learn about functions of management, how the management process functions, what are the steps involved in it, and why this process is conducted in a sequential manner, what are its limitations and effects and advantages, all will be taken in detail. So today's lecture aims at telling you about all the aspects of management. So to begin with, you can look at the picture on your screens. What do you see? Can you see the man in this picture? What is he doing? The man in the picture is shown to have many hands more than usual. These hands are performing multiple tasks, and all these tasks are timed well so that all can be given equal importance. So you can see that management is cannot be carried by one hand. It has to be done by many hands, though a person has only two hands. These other hands are of the subordinates, of the colleagues, of the teachers, or the members of his team who help in performing all these functions. So let us take up in detail all these functions of management one by one. Moving on to the functions, according to Henry Foyle, to manage is to forecast and plan, to organize, to command and to control. He tells us what managing comprises of. He believes that managing would include predicting how certain tasks can be performed so that desired goals can be achieved. Planning would have to be done regarding the structuring, the resources and so on. After planning everything, organizing resources so that the working can be done, and then resources and planning is executed by giving command and they are controlled by the leader. So all this comprises the management functions. Let us discuss what Gulick has to say about functions of management. Gulick has given five acronym words, which is POSTCORB, POSDCORB. POSTCORB means planning, organizing, staffing, directing, coordination, reporting, and budgeting. All these are arranged in short form: P for planning, O for organizing, S for staffing, D for directing, CO for coordination, R for reporting, and B for budgeting. The planning aspect is clear to us. Organizing needs to take care of arranging efficient labor, one that is suited to the demands of the tasks. It needs to be ensured that labor serves the purpose it is hired for. Coordination involves integrating all the performance of participants within a network. They should all have a distinct idea of what the final goals are. The tasks are subdivided into smaller units and performed by the groups, and these are controlled by the manager or the leader. And for this, some leaders may also be appointed for smaller units if divided. Let us then move on to discuss such functions in detail. Now, learners, please look at the slide. What do you see? There are two pictures where in one picture you can see a person who is explaining something on a chart paper and others are looking on. The person who is explaining seems to be the leader. Moving on to the next picture, one person is sitting away from the line of two opposite sides. What does the person in white who is sitting alone depicts? He is the leader, and the people sitting on the opposite sides are the members or the colleagues or the teachers to whom he is explaining how the work shall be done. In this way, both these pictures are depicting how the leader functions in a workplace or in a structure of a project. The first step in this is planning. Planning is a management process concerned with defining goals for company's future direction and determining on the missions and resources to achieve those targets. To meet the goals, managers may develop plans such as business plan or a marketing plan. Planning always has a purpose. So the first function of management is planning. When planning is done properly, the next step can be done easily or taken up easily. So planning always has a purpose and it has to be done properly with certain structure. If the planning is not perfect, the execution will be imperfect. Let us understand what it means to plan and how it contributes to the entire process of management. Planning includes certain setting goals and deciding the best possible manner to achieve them in an efficient way. It is done by keeping the mission and vision of institute in focus. Managers will often need to construct plans on present situation and what is to be achieved in future and open it for suggestions. So planning needs certain vision in the person, the leader, and this mission and vision is carried out with the help of his subordinates or colleague. And all these planning depends on the present situation in which the institution is or the workplace is. The planning and keeping in mission and vision in mind helps us to achieve better possible ways how we can propagate in life and how the organization stands in the society. So for the development of our organization, planning is the basic fundamental step of management. Now the planning includes certain steps. The first step in planning includes setting of goals. We cannot proceed with planning unless and until we have certain set goals. This gives the leader as well as the performers or participants of how one should proceed with the task and what they are able to establish by accomplishing the task. The goals will also provide everyone with an orientation and outlook about their performance. After setting the goals, selecting appropriate strategies and approaches comes next. This is necessary as the manner is almost as important as the task itself. Once the goals and strategies have been established, it is necessary to prepare for the stages following the planning stage. Now we have to plan the steps which are to be followed after the planning stage. The planning has been done, the time comes how to approach the plans and execute them easily and successfully. For this, look at the picture given. What can you see in the figure? The person carrying out files, on the box is written keep. And on the box laid down on the floor, it is written toss. On the above picture, you are seeing the boxes in which certain files are kept and a tag is attached to the boxes. They are even given color code for each day. The entire system is so well organized that it makes it easier to sort through the files. The other picture shows how the man has been sorting through possessions and has come to the conclusion of what is worthy enough to be kept and what is to be tossed or thrown away. He has neatly labeled the things so that there is no confusion. So organization is another step after planning, which is necessary to be kept in mind while managing things and doing things. Planning and then organizing things helps us in executing the plans. Organizing is the management function that usually follows after planning. As I told you, the next step is organizing, and after planning properly, organizing becomes easy. And it involves the assignment of tasks, the grouping of tasks into departments, and the assignment of authority with adequate responsibility and allocation of resources across the organization to achieve common goals. In this way, the organization helps to move on to our next step of process, which is to be implementation of the planning. Whatever is planned needs to be organized sequentially. If there is logical organization, the system can move on easily. Organizing human resources and material resources is important. The best organizing mantra we can say is maximum output from minimum input. That means the whatever resources are available that have to be used maximally to get out the maximum output. It is not necessary to get anything done very nicely in a maximum level. The resources, the raw material, the inputs or the resources should be maximum. Even with minimum inputs, minimum resources, much can be achieved. And that is the best organizing mantra in the organizing world. Now look at the picture. What do you see in the top picture? The hand is doing. Do you think the hand is in a certain position? Can you see the body language of the people? Look at the next picture. Can you see the various screen within the picture and the people looking at the figure in front of the screen? What do you think they are doing? What do you think the female figure is doing? The first picture contains the hand of a manager or leader picking up people one by one standing in the row. Some of the people are running towards the hand, willing to be chosen. They are looking at the hand expectantly to be chosen. And in the second figure, you can see that female figure is gesturing with her hands as if presenting herself to the people, most probably managers or leaders of an organization. She is trying to convince them why she should be chosen. Some of the leaders on the screens are looking at the paper, which is most likely her resume or application, searching for whether she is correct for the job or the task they have in mind. Both these pictures you see are giving you a view that certain selection procedure is going on, whether a person is giving his resume or presenting himself through interview, or the people are running with their jobs, with briefcases, with their files, with their necessary documents to get the job. All these pictures are expressing something, and this is written in your slide. It is written as staffing. Staffing means the process of hiring suitable candidates according to their knowledge and skills in an organization is termed staffing. Staffing therefore means selecting the best possible people for the job. These are the people who will undertake the tasks that make a difference in the running of organization. The manager will need to interact with them on a regular basis, thus needing them to be communicative and open about their performance and efficiency. The members chosen will probably present for the entirety of the task. Let us now list the elements of staffing and how each element is necessary to the process of staffing. There are certain things which should be kept in mind while keeping the people as a staff. First of all, the first thing to be kept in mind in focus is human resources. So human resources is in focus, and it will be noted by many how human resources is an asset to the management process. But the human aspect is error prone too. Therefore, the work has to be assigned carefully. And for the assignment of work, the skills and capabilities has to be seen. And if required, the people with necessary qualification are hired. If the people are not present in an organization with the required skills and capability, obviously staffing is necessary. When staffing is done, then appropriate division of labor, that means allotting proper work to the proper person, is to be done. And for this, the person has to be seen whether he possesses those skills or capabilities or not. Now look at the figure displayed on your screen. There are two slides, pictures. One, the above one, where red one is giving direction to the blue people seated on the chairs. And in another picture, you can see an orange figure standing who is giving directions to the people sitting on the chair. In both the pictures, you can see that one person seems to be the leader who is directing the people for the work. So let us understand the next topic, next content, which is directing or leading the people or subordinates. According to Human, directing consists of process or technique by which institution can be issued and operations can be carried out as originally planned. Therefore, directing is the function of guiding, inspiring, overseeing and instructing people towards accomplishment of organizational goals. Direction is function of where a manager leads a team. His task is not limited to assigning duties. He has to take care that the duties are assigned or performed by the function to the best of their abilities. The members may sometimes land in fix as to how they should proceed, and in this juncture, the director comes into, the leader comes into play, who guides them, who directs them, and makes sure that the members are not distracted and follow his instruction properly. That means he should act as a supervisor and observes the entire nature. Now let us understand what directing or leading actually comprises of. In this direction, the leader gives direction not only to the new staff but also the old one, as they also need direction at different times. So we cannot say that old staff does not need any direction or lead, because they are equally new to the new project. In this case, the leader includes motivating for efficient working. He motivates them, he reinforces his staff and gives a proper positive direction so that they can tread that path and move towards the success. During this direction, the leader also provides the necessary supervision and guidance to the staff so that they are under regular observation of what they are doing, whether they are proceeding in right path or not. And if they deviate, and if they are deviating or tend to deviate, the guidance is given at that proper time by the leader. Next, the leader has to applaud the subordinates or the members for effective work. If he wants that the people should work efficiently, he should applaud them, he should encourage them for their effective work. And this will help them to move further in their process work. Personal skills and communication also play a great role. Unless and until there is a communication between the leader and the subordinate, the work cannot proceed smoothly. Therefore, regular interaction should be there so that whatever the problems are arising or whatever hurdles are coming in between, they can be overcome with the help of leader. And in this manner, the leader helps to improve the personal skills of his subordinates. Now look at the next picture carefully. Very interesting picture, very expressive picture. There are two pictures you can see. In the above picture, you see a man standing near the screen. What is he doing? What do you think he holds in his hand? What are two people seated doing in the image? Look at the another picture. There is a word written on it, team. What is the word team denoting here? How are the people arranged on the word denoting? The red picture shows that the people are expressing their ideas and suggestions to each other and they are listening to each other. They are giving proper feedback. Some are working on their project with concentration. The woman is smiling, expressing her approval at the man's presentation. Now look at the picture word team. Various people form a part of team and all symbolize each letter. So these letters come together to form a team and team works for the success of a work. All of them have a certain role to play. Let us understand how each member forms a part of the team and are interdependent in one or other way. Coordination. There should be coordination between the members of the team. Coordination is the unification, integration, synchronization of the efforts of group members so as to provide unity of action in the pursuit of common goals. According to Mooney and Riley, coordination is orderly arrangement of group efforts to provide unity of action in the pursuit of common goals. According to Charles Worth, coordination is the integration of several parts into an orderly whole to achieve the purpose of understanding. So we have understood what coordination is on the basis of this definition. Just encapsulated in it, you can say that coordination includes analyzing the reason behind the problem, measuring accomplishment of all the members of the team, controlling any sort of deviation or distraction, coordinating things with good control, and this is the work to be taken up by the leader where he looks upon all these aspects. This also includes analyzing reasons behind the problem. He also measures the accomplishment, whether the person has been able to solve the problem, whether the team has worked together to solve that problem. He should be able to control the deviation, to see that the members of the problem controlling team is able to do the work without being deflected or deviated from the focus point. The leader coordinates things with good control and ability. Now, he also compares previous and recent performances to see whether the proper control and coordination is being done. He ensures correction if required. Well-integrated performance is required in this control and coordination aspect. A well-managed job includes proper decision-making and applying it efficiently. So, the control and coordination is a very important aspect and function of any management process. A well-managed job moves in a proper direction and leads all of them to the path of success. Now, look at another image projected before you. What do you see in this image? In the first image, you see how the person with red file is telling something to the woman seated. In the another, you can see a person is showing something to the person seated. The person seated seems to be leader, where the standing person is telling him about something. What do you infer from this picture? You can see that he is giving some report to his leader. The same goes for the both the pictures, as in the first case through the file he is reporting, and in the second case he is reporting via the computer screen. The seated person seems to be leader and looking at the reporting part very nicely and observantly. The subordinates are reporting to the leader. I hope you must have guessed what are we going to talk about now. Obviously, whatever the work has been done, whatever has been the efforts behind the management process, it has to be reported somewhere. And this is the next aspect, which is the reporting aspect. Reporting is the regular provision of information to decision maker within an organization to support them in their work. Reports can be distributed in form of print, in form of email, or assessed via a corporate intranet. Reporting can be used in another mean for verification and cross-checks. Reporting is exchange of information which can be used by the leader to understand where the project is. It can also be used to keep a check on the progress of the members regularly without continuous supervision. So, reporting is equally important. Now, let us see what purpose reports serve. Why reports are necessary? Whatever is organized, managed, and assessed must be kept as a report. So, we know that report is an important aspect of a management process. You must know that reports helps to evaluate the functions performed and result obtained. It helps to give guidelines for future ventures. So, reporting is a necessary step, as you have a record of all that has gone through, all the efforts which have been shown by subordinates, by the employees, by the leaders, and reports can be kept for future suggestions, for future reference. Therefore, reports are equally important as other steps of management process. Now, let us look at another slide which is projected before you. There are two pictures. What do you see in the image? Can you see any object in the images? What are they being used for? One of them is a calculator. Two hands in the image are busy punching in numbers from a pocket diary. The other image consists of currencies, and two words can be made out of the clipboard: monthly budget. It is clear that the members are busy allocating budgets to certain tasks. See, learners, whatever projects or work we undertake, budget is always involved in it. The finances are always involved in it. Without money, no work can be carried out, and everyone knows it very well. So, the money spent or kept must be recorded somewhere. What is the requirement? How much money is required? How much is spent? How much more can be used? How much more can be cut down or curtailed? So, all these comes under the topic budgeting. So, budgeting is equally important for the whole management process, because without money, no work. And therefore, comes the next step, the budgeting step. Budgeting is done during planning stage, or it can be done at the end of the program. So, budgeting is a tool which is used to assess the finances expended or which are to be acquired or needed for the process. The purpose of budgeting tools are to provide a forecast of revenues and expenditure, that is, construct a model of how a business might perform financially if certain strategies, events, and plans are carried out. Tools enable the actual financial operation of the business to be measured against the forecast. The tools, that is the budget tools, establish the cost constraint for a project, program, or operation. Therefore, tools are very, very important. This budgeting, the process, the whole process has to be according to the budgets allocated. So, budget is done during planning stage, as I have already told you, or it can be done at the end of the process to see what has been done regarding the financial aspect. It is also used as corrective measure at implementation stage. That is, when the program is being implemented, then also the budgeting can be done. Moreover, it can also be used at evaluation and reporting stage where the performance according to the budget can be compared. So, budgeting can be done at any stage, at the planning stage or at the end of the stage or at the both level during the planning stage or at the end of the process when the work has been done. So, learners, we have gone through the functioning of the management, and to recap it into summary, let us see this slide before you. You can see there are five principal functions of management. As you can see, they are planning, organizing, and then implementing and coordinating, and then see the controlling and how to evaluate and assess, and then accordingly you should be able to take the action. So you can just go through the slide. The planning includes identify goals and determine the best course of action required to achieve those goals. Next comes organizing, which says assign responsibilities to the employees with detailed skill sets needed to complete the task. The third is staffing, where hire the right people for the right proportion to help the organization achieve its objective through these right positions. Coordinating and controlling by the supervision, communication, direction and monitoring the performance so that the goals can be achieved. And the two things which we talked about was reporting and budgeting. They are in between, which are not mentioned in the summary, but they are equally important, as reporting is to be kept of the whole functions of the management, and budgeting, as I have already told you, the finances are equally important when a work is taken up as a project. So I hope today you understood in this lecture the principle of functions and how the main functions of management process are, and you would have understand all these steps properly. Thank you.